everybody. This is Bjorn Clausen calling, and as you know, this Saturday there was the national selection for our participants in the Eurovision Song Contest here in Denmark. And you might probably also know who won that. I won't tell you in case you don't, but most of us do. Now, this is what I want to do. I want to go through each single song, and I want you to give my view on how they did, how good the song is, and if they didn't win, what was wrong, what happened. Yeah. So, I'll take it from the beginning. Let's start out with song number one. Now, that was Anita Haik with Copenhagen Airport. What I think of first of all this song, it's quite poppy, isn't it? Very, very poppy. And that's kind of the Danish Eurovision type, I think. So really, you can't discriminate that. I think it's all right for it to be poppy. That it's about Copenhagen Airport, I guess songs have to have a theme. Now about this performance, I didn't feel that she went through as well as she did in the semi-finals. Her hair was different. In the semi-finals she had more of like the Corolla effect going on. That was quite cool actually. But also the dancers, speaking of Corolla, the dancers are like totally her. I don't know, but I don't think the average Dane would even notice that. Also, she seemed very nervous comparing to the semi-finals. She was more smiling in the semis, and she just seemed more confident. However, she did sing much better in the finals, so that's what I think of that. Now, we will go on to song number two. But somebody sets the earth on fire, and somebody tries to poison your mind. Oh yeah, yeah, two of us stronger than one. We have to go on. Gentlemen, with me and my. Now, first of all, thank God they changed the outfits. Oh my goodness. In the semi-final, they had these, like, cartoon heroes costumes, you know, kind of Batman meets whoever. It was horrid. Yuck! So thank God they changed the costumes. To the better. Now, the song is quite alright, I think. It's really good, actually. It has a strong melodic value. It's not like dip-dip-dip-dip-dip-dip. It's not quite as easily remembered, but still, it does it still has quality. And about the performance that night, I think it was kind of over the top. The way they acted, Like, ah, oh, Tyrion, ooh. That was a bit too much in the end, and that's, yeah, that's what I think went wrong. So, indeed. You know what? I think we should go on to song number 3. Like a dream, I can take you away in a second or two. I can show you a magical place, but it's all up to you. And that was Annika Eskman with Fly. Now, I'm actually quite fond of her, I might say. The song is very strong. It's a bit rock edge, kinda. And she has a very, very powerful voice. Also, did you hear the quality of her live performance? You know, just the quality of her voice. It could have been a CD recording. I wouldn't have been able to hear the difference, you know. She's just a very, very, very good singer. Now, what I don't like about the performance is the whole, you know, band on stage thing. I don't know how to explain it. I just think that a song like that would have been stronger as a single performance, you know, where it would just be her and maybe some choir and stuff. I think that would really have suited it. Yeah, that's it. So, let's go on with song number 4.